In today's video, we're discussing Premier African Minerals. We're going to discuss the new RNS. We're going to do a bit of a recap of exactly why we're invested in Premier African Minerals. We're also going to look at the share price, and we're going to look at the future predictions, hopefully, of where this baby is going to go. Welcome back, everyone, to Buy, Hold, Sell. I hope, of course, you are all well. Let's have a look at Premier African Minerals share price to start off with. We can see we are down another 8% at the start of the day. On the week, we are down 17%. On the month, 26%. On the 6 month, 67%. And the year to date, 22%. But the real killer is on the year, we are down 69%. But from the highs to the current price, we are down 83%. Needless to say, there is a lot of people feeling a lot of pain. If we strip this out, we can actually see here that we are back to the prices that when I first started investing in PREM, we are at these prices, which is just mind-blowing how the leadership of this ship that we are on has crashed into every iceberg, every rock, every ship, every vessel, anything that has been in the way. This thing has went straight into it. Horrible. But we're balls deep. People in the last video were complaining that I was very bearish, saying, oh, you used to be bullish on it now, leave us be, we're invested in it. I'm invested in it too. As I said before, I love my wife, but sometimes we argue. That's just what happens. I'm going to show you full transparency, as always, in my Discord. I share all my trades. If you're interested in Discord, links down below. But transaction history, these are the buys that I have put in over the last sort of 6-7 months since this thing has been falling like a stone. I preach about trading support levels, resisting levels, and how to do that. The reason I do that is because it allows me to not just buy every 5% dip or 2% dip. I try my best to time my buys. And as you can see, based on the news and different situations that we found ourselves in, my last buy was on the 15th of December at 23p. I told everyone I was waiting at least for 0.2 for my next top up. Based on everything we talked about in the last video, the placement was at that level. It's going to go to that level. Before I could top up at that level, we have further had bad news that came out last week and then today. So again, I cancelled my order. I was in Amsterdam at the weekend and I cancelled my order so it wouldn't be fulfilled. Then more news has come out and now I've reassessed, told my Discord 0.16 has got to be your target now. And we've already pretty much hit that today. At one stage, it was below 0.17. You can actually see how much I've invested and how much my balance is for any of those that are interested. But if I actually scroll down here, a lot of people have been buying. I also bought today. I made a bit of a balls up on my order. I actually placed two orders at the same price and paid a fee twice. So that was a bit foolish. But either way, 0.17 is what I bought. I was trying to adjust it to get 0.165. I'm bought. My average price now sits at 0.389, you might as well say. I'm content enough with my price. I'm going to be looking to buy one more probably load of PREM, but not quite yet. And the reason being is because of today's RNS. What I want to say about George Rose is you look at the mannerisms, you look at the way he conducts himself on Stockbox interviews, things that don't matter. Anyone that thinks a Stockbox interview matters, it really doesn't. It's just a YouTube channel of a couple of guys interviewing a CEO. It means nothing. But he's using that platform, in my opinion, to dust over the hard facts. And the hard facts you find in the RNSs, that's what's legal. That's what would stand up in court if this was to ever end up in court, if it was a legal dispute or issues or whatever CanMax have agreed to. The legal facts, that's where you find it. Disregard all the other guff. And I've been saying that for a while now because there's a lot of people hurting, including myself. And you've kind of just got to look at the signs here and be honest with yourselves and know your risks. So in this video, we're going to look at some positives and we're going to look at the risks. But let's get straight into the actual RNS itself. So Zulu, for those that don't know, is currently mining in the North and South Pit areas with plans to release a resource statement in Q1 2024, primarily focusing on the sapodium tonnage. Now, the mineral classification, the main interest of Zulu is the sapodiuming, and the resource estimate emphasizes the importance of considering mineral assemblage in addition to the grading. Sapodium recovery is a key focus, and the deposit is classified as SQI dominant, which is very, very good. That's what you want, obviously. Plant upgrades are underway, including UV sorter enhancements and installation of new thickener to improve the slurry flow. Now, we've heard about this before. Stark involved this is probably quite a decent positive news that came out of it. The new ball mill is expected to arrive in late January. That has been consistent in the last few RNSs, along with other necessary equipment. The production costs are estimated to be around 800 per tonne of sodium concentrate, with the current pricing market production marginally profitable. It's been a huge decline in the sodium prices over the last 12 to 18 months. This shouldn't really come as any great surprise. So don't look at this as a negative that it says it's marginally profitable. The key thing is here that it is profitable. And right now, for those that don't know, a shout out to Keith, because we had a bit of a discussion about this today. The current assets of Premier African Minerals is actually worth more than the current market cap. That's the scenario. The market is looking at Premier African Minerals and goes, you're worth 0.17. Your market cap is around 45 million. Assets alone are worth more than that. That's just crazy to me. And that is an indication fundamentally that we are very low valued at the current state of affairs. Funding and expansion. Premier is exploring funding options due to expansion related cash constraints. This is something I touched about in the previous video. I'm not going to go into it too much. We know further dilution would come to fund things. What I don't understand is why we keep needing money when we haven't delivered on the things that we raised money for previously. That's it. Not going to say no more about it. Then we had our CEO statement. He is confident about the Zulu's project progress and aims to begin production. And here's the key thing. Late February 2024. If you do some fact checking, you'll see this is the RNS came out only in the 7th of December. So you're talking over a month ago just, and reverating January production. And here's the thing. So it says bye. So he's trying to be clever here. He's not fooled me. He has changed the word buy to late. And I put this in the Discord a few weeks ago. This target originally started as January. Then it became end of January. Then it became by February. And now it's becoming end of February. Somehow, out of nowhere, we've just added an extra 2 months on. This just keeps getting further and further delayed. And that is part of the reason why the market's selling off. If you recall the RNS previously, he says, I'm fully focused on this now, because he was distracted with Lord knows what, because this should be his full focus. But anyway, he was distracted with doing something else. Now he's fully balls deep, eyes over it. He's brought in a team of expertise. This is going to happen. Only a month later, it looks like, once again, you don't know what's happening from month to month. Now, to be positive, being in the construction trade myself, I know projects get delayed absolutely all the time. It actually does happen. Biggest projects in the world, smallest projects in the world, even an extension on your house will likely run into delays. And I allowed for those delays. This isn't one of the greatest construction projects of all time. This is very much a bog standard mill that's through on the back of a dirt track road. This shouldn't take such a long time to put right. If they haven't put it right, they need to look around them and look at their subcontractors, or look at whoever is making the decisions and whoever's failing, because somebody's failing. Not once, not twice, but consistently is a failure, and they need put out of the contract. I just fear that it could be actually George himself. Nonetheless, we have a date again as the end of February, which is about a month away now to try and get this into production. But he did say Q1 as well. So now I wouldn't be surprised if this gets pushed out for another month, say to the end of March. So I'm going to allow for the end of March as my reasonable expectation of and this will be the final last straw for me. It's not all doom and gloom as much as it may feel like that. Let's have a look at the charts here. We drew all these support levels, and it breaks my heart to say that we fell through every single one of them. Now we're at this level. So what you'll find is the 0.23 area will now become resistance, and it will be difficult to break that. Big news, like, we're in production, should make this thing pop and break us out of that. I still believe 0.6 is fair value for Premier African Minerals, as I've said now for about the last 3-4 months. Unfortunately, based on the sodium prices, based on the delay, based on the further dilution to come, based on we're marginally going into profit, based on all that, 0.6 seems fair to me. This is your price target then, 0.16. This should be well respected level. Couldn't break above, couldn't break above, couldn't break down, couldn't break down. And these kind of levels are going back as far as May 2018. It's truly, truly remarkable, because what I drew here now really falls into this channel. I wouldn't be surprised if this is what we kind of see between now and production, really. I hope any bad news will sink us below this. And this is what I'm really concerned about, because if it sinks below this, then the next natural position, and I can't believe every video I'm doing, I'm having to show you the next low point, because it just seems to be a falling dagger at the moment. At a stretch, you're probably talking here, 0.112, which would mean at these levels, you're seeing roughly another 24%. So again, this is why you got to learn how to buy and support and trade levels. It's not a promo. I don't want to sell my course. Buy it if you're interested. Don't. I don't really care. It's there for people, that want to know this stuff. If you don't, forget about it. It's all right. That's the grimness. Now, let's try and end the video in a positive manner, shall we? The positives are we're at a 52-week high, still at 0.14. I'm not to talk about the bearish side of things, but if worst comes to worst and we had to, if this wasn't feasible no more, the likelihood is CanMax will make a bid probably for the full entire Zulu project at 100%, which is usually means the 52-week high will be bought. And I'm sure at this stage of 0.17, a lot of people would be more than happy to sell this in and around that 1p, because that 1p area would give you around nearly five times your money, which would give you almost 500% upside, which is lovely. Anybody who's not in Prem right now, what a time to be alive. I'd definitely be considering managing the risk, obviously, and knowing the risks, but I would definitely consider purchasing some Prem for the risk reward ratio. If we get up to the fair value price that I said roughly is around this type of level, we're seeing a 234% upside. It's hard to sort of talk about a positive because it kind of also makes you think about a negative. The negative being, obviously, 52-week high is all well and good, but come sort of mid-May, that 52-week high then becomes 7th of June and you just follow it the whole way down. You don't want to be in this scenario come November, say, because November, then your average, your high, 52-week high is 0.33. And this is where it gets interesting with CanMax. People are worried about CanMax moving away. I don't think they will. I think you have to bear in mind their shareholders. They've took a pound in as well. They still want the supportamine. It's small money to them. So for them, it would make sense to walk away from this. Worst case scenario is they can't deliver. They go in and buy the resource anyway, probably at a huge discount. So it doesn't feel like they're going to walk away. Definitely not anytime soon. So I don't think you need to worry about that. And as long as CanMax are involved, I take comfort in that. I think we'll be handsomely rewarded if you hold long on Premier African Minerals, which it should have always been a long hold. But I appreciate a lot of people are feeling the pain, just as I. That's why I shared the pain in my Discord and everyone can see the types of losses that I'm taking. It's a long hold. Manage your risk, understand risks. Don't go all in on penny stocks, as I keep saying. And everything should hopefully be okay. But again, guys, the facts are what the facts are. Delays are happening. Further dilution is happening. And we don't seem to be any further than where we were 6 months ago to production. New machinery, new ball mills, new UV sorters or whatever else, technical stuff that's been installed, it's all well and good. But if you can't get the stuff in and can't get it out the other end, it doesn't really matter what you've got installed. Another positive would be that Prem doesn't have any debt right now. We have potential loans and debts that we'll need pay by 2025 to CanMax, and obviously the penalty for further delays and different things like that. But in theory, we have no debt. And as I said, it's crazy that we've spent more money on building the Zulu plant than what the current market cap is. And there's something very unsettling with me about that. We've spent more money than what we have. It makes no sense really at a high level. But if you look at it from the positive point of view, surely the love of God, we must be near the bottom now. I'm feel comfortable buying at these levels. I have bought at these levels, and we will keep monitoring the progress of the Zulu project with the next update and the next video, I'm sure. But every day we're chatting about it in the Discord. If you're interested in any of the stuff that we talked about, trading courses or Discord links or whatever, links are down below. I will catch you all in the next video. Hope you also found this one informative. Sorry if it feels bearish, but a spade's a spade, guys. You've got to call it. There is plenty of potential. Go back and watch some of the videos from about 6, 7, 8 months ago. Everything we talked about in those videos still stands. You know, if we get into production, this will be fantastic and only the beginning for Prem, but we need to get there first. Catch you in the next video. Please like, subscribe.